So for today's batch of embed powder, I'm going to be making some blue embed powder. Hey guys, I am back with another video, and today's video is gonna be super interesting because I am going to be talking all about embed powder. And in this video, I will explain what it is, how I make it, and I will also address Lush's patent on this process and what that means for bath bomb businesses like myself if we decide to use this patent in products that we sell. If you're new here, hello, my name is Jerrica. I am the owner and creator of Quench, and on this channel, I talk all about my bath bomb and soap business. And if that is something that you're interested in, maybe you're also starting a business yourself, or maybe you're already full swing into this type of business and just wanna know what others are doing, this is the channel for you. And now without further ado, let's get into it. So what is embed powder? Embed powder is the powder that I use inside of my bath bombs. And that powder is a different color than what the bath bomb on the outside looks like. So it's like a surprise color when the bath bomb dissolves, it shoots out and it makes a really cool effect in the bathtub. And this is how Lush does it. For their bath bombs, they usually include an embed inside of their bath bombs that has a different baking soda to citric acid ratio than the actual bath bomb in itself. So the traditional baking soda to citric acid ratio for a bath bomb is normally 2 parts baking soda to 1 part citric acid. Lush's embed is different from that, and I don't know exactly what the ratio is. And what this causes in their bath bombs is when the water touches that embed inside of their bath bomb, it dissolves quicker than the actual bath bomb itself, which creates this really cool shooting star effect. And if you add color to that, then that is what creates their amazing bath art that they are so famous for. This is a process that Lush actually invented, and they have an approved, legally enforceable utility patent on this specific process. Their patent for the 2-layer bath bomb was issued in 2014, meaning that this patent protects their process up until 2034. If you want to check out the full details of that patent, I will also include the patent in the description below. And just for clarity, this patent isn't a design patent, so it doesn't address colors or a specific mold. It's specifically for the process itself. Now, can I make a bath bomb using this process? Of course you can. You can definitely do it. But can you sell this type of product? Legally, no. And if you decide to use this patent process in products that you sell, know that Lush can enforce their patent at any time and sue you for patent infringement. And I know that most of you guys are small fry like me. That's probably something that you don't want to deal with. It would be like David going against Goliath. I myself do not sell products using Lush's patent. My bath bomb dust inside of my bath bombs, their baking soda to citric acid ratio is identical to the baking soda to citric acid ratio of the main bath bomb. And if you're wanting to add a secret color inside of your bath bomb, then I suggest and recommend that you do it this way too. So I will show you guys exactly how I do this right now. So for today's batch of embed powder, I'm going to be making some blue embed powder using water-soluble dyes, and I love using the water-soluble dyes from fizzfairy.ca. The rest of the ingredients, all you will need is baking soda, citric acid, and some water, and that's it. So when it comes to a traditional bath bomb recipe, it's normally 2 parts baking soda to 1 part citric acid. If you guys have been following me since the beginning of my YouTube journey, you guys know I do not follow that. For my actual bath bombs, my ratio is closer to a 1.5 to 1 baking soda to citric acid ratio. And because my ratios are not the traditional 2 parts baking soda to 1 part citric acid, I feel that my bath bombs have kind of a unique quality to them in the bathtub. So when it comes to making my embed powder, I use that same ratio. I mix those two elements together, and then I add the bath bomb dye, and then I add water, and that's it. And I'll show you that entire process right now. Now normally when I'm making my bath bombs, I dissolve the bath bomb dye in a little bit of water, but for my embed, I'm just going to put the bath bomb dye directly into this mix. Super easy. And when it comes to bath bomb embeds, I like the color to be super vibrant, so I use two of these mini scoops, and I think a scoop of this is the same as a quarter teaspoon, so I guess that would be half a teaspoon. Kale, what's two quarter teaspoons together? Is that half a teaspoon? Okay, half a teaspoon. You heard it from the resident math expert himself. So half a teaspoon of bath bomb dye to the embed mix. Now the next step is to bind all of these ingredients together and to activate the dye. And what I'll be using is just regular water. And what that will do is cause the bath bomb mix to bind together just like it would for a normal bath bomb. And it will also cause the bath bomb dye in there to activate, and you'll get that beautiful blue color. Continue to add water to this mix until the mix is wet enough to come together when I press it and not fall apart. And you don't have to be as careful with this stuff as you are with your regular bath bomb mix, because this is embed powder, and if it falls apart and crumbles, that's perfectly okay. What we're making is embed powder, not bath bombs. And as you can see here, it's not quite ready. It still falls apart when I crush it together, so I need to keep adding more water at this point. So I think we're there. When I press it together, it stays. So this is actually perfect. And now we're gonna move on to the next step. As most of you guys know, I love recycling materials that other soap suppliers send to me. And one of the things that I love to save are these big plastic bags that conceal. And I love using these bags specifically for bath bomb embeds, because I could just stuff it in there and it provides a great container for my bath bomb embeds. So now that I have my mix here, super heavy, oh gosh, I'm going to scoop that mix into the bag and I'll show you what I do after that. Now that I have it all in this bag, I'm going to seal it for now, just for now, and I'm going to try to flatten this out. So I'll show you what I mean right now. So now that I have the bag full of embed powder, I opened up the end here so that this stuff can breathe and dry out over time. And what it will actually do is get hard, just like an actual bath bomb will. And once it gets hard and I let it harden overnight, I'm going to break it up, and then I have my embed powder. It's just that easy. So all it was citric acid, baking soda, a little bit of water, and bath bomb dye. There wasn't any fragrance oil added because I don't need it to smell like anything, and there was no additional oils or other stuff like the kaolin clay and the SLSA added. I used to make little cubes of embeds, but it honestly took so much time, and ooh, I'm really bright. And this method takes a fraction of that time, and I get a lot of embed powder that I can use in my bath bombs. And I noticed that this lasts way longer than the little cubes I used to make. So if you're thinking about adding a surprise color in your bath bomb, this is the way I suggest that you do it. So this is what it actually looks like the next day. This is my purple embed powder. And as you can see, it clumps together. You just have to crush it. And how hard these embeds are depends on how much water you use. So try not to use too much, or they end up becoming really super rock hard and hard to break apart. And this powder here is what I put inside of my bath bombs and what you've seen in my videos. And that causes beautiful color to shoot out of the bath bomb as a surprise, all without infringing on Lush's patent. And that's Kale in the background. He's been busy.
You can hear me squeaking around.
Yeah. He's been really busy packing orders. So that is it. I really hope you found this kind of video helpful. If you want the exact recipe that I used, you'll find that in the video description down below. And if you did find this super helpful and entertaining, then please subscribe. We passed 20,000 subscribers. Oh my God, that is just insane. I did promise a giveaway, so we are definitely in the works of planning that. And the details of that will be out in the next video. Next week on Tuesday. I've decided on an upload schedule of Tuesday and Friday, so keep an eye out for Tuesday's video because I will talk all about how you guys can get your hands on a beautiful package of Quench products as a thank you for watching and following me on this channel. Thank you guys for joining me on my journey, and continue being awesome, continue smiling, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.